President Bush says the battle against Islamic extremists will take a long time. My next guest says that is in part because of the American people. In her new book, Death of the Grown-Up, How America's Arrested Development is Bringing Down Western Civilization, Diana West claims that the baby boomer generation is too spoiled and self-absorbed to understand America's many challenges, including the radical Islamist terror threat, and she joins me now. This is a fascinating read, I mean, on so many different levels, but I want to first start out that there you open it up and you talk about your family situation, how you spent a year in Ireland, and then yes. Fast forward, what the events of 9/11 really helped shape and form this book. Tell me about that.
Well, the year in Ireland was significant only because it took me out of American culture and then put me back into it, a different person. I think any time you leave your culture, you come back a little bit someone else. I actually started working on the book about 10 years ago. Back when we had a president named Clinton, we had a big scandal involving a White House intern, and what really struck me about the whole way the scandal unfolded was the fact that I decided Bill Clinton thought the country was more grown up than he was, because if you remember those first televised pictures of Bill Clinton on the revelations about Monica Lewinsky, he looked like he was a cooked goose. And in retrospect, it struck me that I believe he thought he was going to be punished. He wasn't. And when I started thinking back on that period, I wanted to find out what had happened to us. How had we gotten to the point where the country was not more grown up than this particular president, who did seem like a poster boy for the death of the grown up?
When you talk about grown ups, you also have in your first chapter, you have some interesting statistics. More adults ages 18 to 49 watch the Cartoon Network than watch CNN. The average video gamester was 18 in 1990. Now he's going on 30. How does this all factor in?
Well, I think that it factors in showing us that we are a culture of perpetual adolescence. We haven't really gotten to the point where we have rediscovered maturity. It kind of went out of style, I guess, in the 1960s. We really seem to be frozen with the sort of model of the sort of countercultural, cool, never quite growing up, flouting authority kind of figure. And that, I think, we do owe to our baby boomers. And that is why we see these statistics like this. There are many others.
And how does this factor in, tie it all in together, on the war on terror? Because your concern is that people are essentially just tuning out, not paying attention, not focused enough, that they are essentially, we don't have grown-ups in this country.
Well, I think that's true. I think that what we saw in that kind of countercultural period in the 1960s was a complete leveling of all sorts of hierarchies, hierarchies of learning, hierarchies of authority. And from that emerged the kind of leveling of cultures. And I think from that comes multiculturalism, in which no culture is any better, any different than any other, except, of course, Western culture usually is denigrated. And from that, I think we get to this point where it becomes very hard for people to discuss the war on radical Islam. It becomes very difficult for people to assess frankly the problems facing us, because they don't want to be considered mean or not inclusive. I think inclusion has become our great virtue. And yet there's a big difference between preserving openness in a society and preserving tolerance. You can't go on forever being tolerant, because you're going to be subsumed.
And you also talk as part of that we lose our identity. We have a
yes.
full screen that I want to pull up. And
okay.
You have a chapter called The Real Culture War, where you call multiculturalism a faith more dangerous to us than jihadist terrorists. You write, from the multicultural teachings of the politically correct classroom, we as a culture have learned to censor incorrect thoughts. In the absence of adults, we have found ways to sidestep taxing responsibilities. What did you mean by that?
Well, it's kind of like the enemy within. I think we've trained ourselves to be judgmental to a fault, and perhaps inspired by very kindly sorts of notions. But there is in this refusal to make judgments, to make distinctions, a loss of ourself. And so to me, the multicultural paradigm that seems to be motivating so much of our discussions fail to allow us to face facts, discuss things rationally as adults, as mature people. And so that is basically what I mean. I feel like we could take on the threats posed to our liberty by expansionist Islam, but not unless we can about them.
Now, we only have about 30 seconds left. What are some of the solutions? Because clearly you've identified as several problems. It's the loss of identity, this essentially this multiculturalism, we don't have grown-ups in this country. Mm. What are some of the solutions?
Well, I think the solutions come with trying to realize where we were and how far we've come down, in the sense. And looking back at that figure about the 30-year-old gamester, and it really also goes back to discovering what makes us Western, what makes us a liberty-based culture, and which is a more benevolent society than what we're up against. So I think it comes to facing facts about who we are and why we need to stay that way.
Diana West, it's a great book. It's called The Death of the Grown-Up, How America's Arrested Development is Bringing Down Western Civilization. It's been a pleasure. Appreciate